Say all praises and honor to you, how Bashem Yahushai, Bashem Rakakodash, and Dublin as the apostles and elders of Greatness Stone. Shalom to all our brothers and out there, pushing truth in all sincerity and in all honesty. This is a brother from James, Jamaica Camp, Yashamai.
I war.
And today we want to have a video on this whole coronavirus, you know, scare, you know, take place right across the world, you know, because you know, you have people, other people in America now, you know, rushing to basically supermarket, you know, to get food. You see, because, you know, the scared basically take place now. We have a lot of people now see that this coronavirus out basically become a pandemic in America. So people are rushing to the stores now, is if basically get things. You see, to which scripture speak about famine. You see, the Lord and Savior, how shall I go in back 2,000 years ago? You can bring it out better for you. You get into the article. You see, me speak about famine and pestilence. I was already see the pestilence. You see, this coronavirus thing was spread. You know, I will see the famine I come now. You see, because, you know, ultimately, you see me, Lord's willing, this will lead to a famine. You see me, worldwide. You see, go up and pray this year. You see, because we tell this society. They are not living in a wicked society like this year. What?
It says, Matthew 24, verse 3.
What?
And as he sat up on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came privately, saying, tell us when shall these things be done, and what shall be the signs of thy coming?
And what shall be the signs of thy coming? What shall be the sign of the Lord? Yahushua, the man of people ignorant, they call Jesus coming. What?
And of the end of the world.
And the end of the world, end of this age. You see me, end of this wicked society. You see, because going back 2,000 years ago, they have the Roman Empire that rule. You see me, I know we now are the second leg of the Roman Empire. So we live that time when all these prophecies come to pass.
Can.
See, go on, brother.
Basically, to talk about the latter days now.
Can. Can it? Last days.
Can.
Go on.
It says, and Yahushua answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive thee.
Can.
For many shall come in my name, saying, I am a Mashiach, and shall deceive many.
Can.
And he shall hear of wars and rumors of wars.
Shall hear about wars and rumors of wars. A lot of basically report coming out, you know, about
wars.
World War III. January of World War III is scared. You know? A lot of people across the world were scared about, you know, World War III kick off because what happened to the Iranian general.
Can.
So this is how the scripture says, I go hear of wars and rumors of wars. Go on.
And if you can check the Middle East right now, you have a lot of wars going on over there.
Turkey.
Because in Turkey and Syria right now, hey, it's over there, it's hot. It's on fire, man. You see reports coming out that even Chinese military ship fire off America.
Yeah, laser fire
America jet.
Can,
so you know, hey. Boy, the rhetoric for war is in the air, man.
Can.
So it's all happening, man. It says, you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars.
Can.
And see that ye be not troubled.
Can.
For all these things must come to pass, the end is not yet.
All these things must come to pass. And the end is not yet. Well, because you still have some certain more prophecies.
Can.
To fulfill. Like, for example, one of the main prophecies we basically look over the years, basically come to pass, is it fully implementing our monetary worldwide at the RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast.
Can.
Go on.
Sin. For nations shall rise against nations, and kingdoms against kingdoms.
Can.
And there shall be famine.
There shall be what? Famine. And that's what we are looking for right now, the famine. You see, because I know you have shortage of food now.
Can.
You know, in Italy, I know we see a lot of people in America now buying up the food, them.
Which is right, man.
You see, so ultimately, you see, they're going to lead to famine. You see, we hope and pray this year, as I mentioned when we started the video.
Can.
Go on.
And pestilence.
Pestilence like diseases. You see, like the coronavirus.
Can. And earthquakes in diverse places.
I see a lot of earthquakes.
And that's been happening, man. Even like 2 days ago, you have earthquake shake in Trinidad.
Can.
A couple of weeks ago, you have earthquake scared in Jamaica. Seen? You have different parts of the world, man. You can check it, earthquake been going off, man. So these are signs at the end, man.
Seen?
So the scripture says, measure all the time diligently, man. Seen? Because, hey, that's what we do as men of the Lord. We're prophets of the Heavenly Father. Seen?
Watch,
and
man.
That's what the Lord gives us this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to do, man. And we bring this word to you people, man. You Negroes, Native Americans, and Latinos, man, which are the children of Israel. Seen? Say, we tell it to look out to what are the signs for the end of the time, and basically they're happening now. Zin? Alright. And that's the job description of a prophet, man. It says you want the article. It says this is an article from Daily Mail. It says this is published 2nd of March 2020 update. Alright, it says panic buying. It's the US as anxious shoppers stockpile food and medical supply. as the number of coronavirus cases surge to 91. So it's on a rise. It's growing, man. It's growing in the United States. A couple of days ago, you heard that it was most nearly one or two somebody infected in America, and it's rising to a high number right now. Then, it says people started stockpiling items from stores across the country over the weekend, as health officials confirmed the first two people had died in the United States from coronavirus. And we see what in Italy, Iran, and some other countries, man, where the death toll arise rapidly, man. Because in Iran, the last report we get, I think about 18 or so dead in Iran. It's the rising of the number in South Korea is high. Japan, Italy, as the brother mentioned before. So guess what? And a lot of people has been panicked, man. They panic over this thing. All the panic are gone, man. Zin. But we as men of the Lord, we're not gonna be in that panic mood, man. Because guess what? Through the Spirit and power of the Lord, the scriptures has revealed these things unto us and show us the boy these things are gonna come to pass. Right. But if we be faithful unto the Lord, we're gonna be protected, man. Right. Zin, from all of these.
Proverbs 3 and verse 25.
The book of Proverbs 3 and verse 25, it says, be not afraid. Proverbs 3 verse 25, it says, be not afraid of sudden fear, neither of the desolation of the wicked when it cometh.
So this is what the scripture says. We're not supposed to be afraid. You see me, of destruction when it cometh. We're not supposed to be afraid like all regular people bug out now, because this whole coronavirus scare will take place.
Which is right, man.
A lot of people are going to buy food. The scripture says, my servant shall eat, but he shall be hungry. Lord, gonna feed him servant, yo.
Which is right, man.
See me, we believe that. You see me, we hope and pray to Yahweh Hashem Yeshai, and give us the faith. You see me, to continue the work until the end, yo.
Hey, but because you know, say you have the protection of the Lord, man, and we are men of the Lord, we're supposed to leave ourselves careless, man. See, this thing come from, because scripture says we must not tempt the Most High, man. So we can't just allow people for ourselves just out there carelessly among these people, man. See, we have to be careful when we're out there also, man. See? It says, for the Lord shall be thy confidence, and shall keep thy foot from being taken. Zin?
Exactly.
Yes, and if you go to Psalms 91, it says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under it. You can get it back.
All right, go on.
So, see Psalms 91. Let's get it, Psalms 91. Psalms 91 verse 1, it says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
God, our secret place of the Most High, the word of the Heavenly Father,
God, which is right,
man. It's true, yo. People say that, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, the righteous run it into, and are safe,
and are safe, man. God,
go on.
It says, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. See? My God, my fortress, my power, in him will I trust, Zin, and not in man. Zin, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence.
From the ICBM missiles that we are going to shoot
right,
off,
man.
You see me? Right across the world, and the land of America, and also on the land of Israel.
You
see me? We know that America is going to fire them ICBM missiles also, and China and Russia, certain other parts of the world are going to get hit.
Which is right.
You see, my Heavenly Father is going to protect us, yeah. See, Lord's willing, we endure the work to the end. Go on.
Right, man. He shall cover thee with his feathers.
Talking about the chariots, so-called white man calling UFOs. Go on.
Can. And under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler.
Can. So this truth.
Word, man.
This word is going to be our shield and buckler, man.
You know, this is the time we're supposed to put on the whole armor of the Almighty, man.
John.
I skipped just the whole armor of Yahweh Hashem Yeshai, because What? You go down and say, the shield of faith.
Right.
The sword, which is the spirit of God. See, which is this word, man. All of that, man. So, basically, at the time, we were supposed to dwell closer and closer to the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahshua, man. Draw nearer and nearer, man. See? It says, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flight by day.
Thou shalt not be afraid of by the terror by night. See, you're going to have a lot of things that take place here.
Which is right, man.
See me? You're going to be the greatest destruction. Learn how to way more worse of things than when back then right. to ancient Egypt. Scripture said that. I walk back then in ancient Egypt. He said, Lord, release a lot of spirits out.
Terror, man.
You see me? And the Egyptian them, a magician them basically, you know, scared. So Scripture said, thou shalt not be afraid of a terror by night. Go on.
It says, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness.
Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, like the diseases.
Can?
You see, because we know you have way more diseases than this basically.
Can?
I go release.
And you see, ask you to come out with a new one, your mom, disease X. Can you know, Ethiopia, man.
Can?
Where it make your hemorrhage through your eyes and your mouth and all different parts of your body, man. Something similar to the Ebola.
Right.
So we know say the so-called white man have a lot of these things to work, man.
Man, release in lab, CDC.
Man. As the scripture says, we are not ignorant of Satan devices.
Right. Satan disease control.
Right.
We know ain't gonna use them yet.
Right.
You see, because we need time now when they move off basically destroy majority of the earth population. You right. see, the new world order plan. Yeah, going back to the Jada Guy's stone, maintain humanity and 500 million.
Right.
So they have a plan to kill off majority of the people on the earth. That's what the bank leader plan you. You see, go on.
Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness.
Go on.
Nor for the destruction that wasteth at noon.
Noonday.
At noonday.
What?
A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand.
A lot of people are going to die around the election.
Which is right.
You see, people are going to jump like fly.
That's a man are going to put on the ground like dung.
Go on. Man, back on.
See? It says, a thousand at thy right hand. It shall, 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee.
Can, because the Heavenly Father is going to protect him elect.
Which is right.
It's all about elect on this side.
It says, only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked.
Can, so only with our eyes are going to see what? The reward of the wicked. And those wicked, they read Malachi 1 and 4, it tells us, Edom, thou shalt call them the God of wickedness.
Wickedness, man.
Which are you so-called white people today. No, so wicked for our people.
Yeah, you can. Because a lot of our people are wicked, man. Because they're gone off of the ways of the so-called white man, man.
And you won't say, wait, you have a bar, shoot, shy. You are weird. So they're going to get judged along with the so-called white man. So you can say, hello, China, and tell them, I get what?
Just true, man. See? It says, because thou hast made the Lord, which is thy refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation.
Right, exactly.
So we're supposed to dwell with the Most High more and more, man, through the word, through the spirit and power of the Lord, man. Go off of the book of the commandments of life. This is it, man. Walk in it, man. This is the way.
Responsibility. Scripture says we're supposed to pray too.
Yeah, can.
To watch as well as pray. I have a scripture now. I think Luke 18, I believe. Say a man must basically always pray not to faint.
Can, which is
so
right,
we live in that time we're supposed to pray now. You see, fast too.
Can.
Because some serious things are going to happen. Night time to come here.
Hey, get yourself in line for what's coming, man. Because we know famine is coming, man.
And all our faith going to get tested.
Yeah, our faith are get tested. And the reason why we need fasting, then, is to train our body, man. So that's when the time comes, we can withstand all the adversity that will come upon us, man. See? The adversity of hunger. Because guess what? Hey, as a man of the Lord, I hunger go face it, man. The famine gonna come and it's gonna face it. See? But at the last end, we are gonna get delivered, man. See, because Lord, the scripture says you cannot be faint hearted, man. See? It says, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plagues come nigh thy dwelling. See?
Exactly.
And this is a plague, man.
Yeah. This coronavirus.
Coronavirus is a plague.
See, COVID-19.
Can, which is right, man. See, if you're abiding on the Lord, man, see, and continue to endure in this word, see, and push the truth, man, and live according to all the scriptures you're supposed to live, man, see, showing brotherly love and all them stuff, man, see, hey, live as one. So we need all of that, man, see. Alright. It says, the two coronavirus-related deaths were confirmed in Washington State and include a resident at the Life Care Center nursing home and patients at the Evergreen Health Hospital. Then, and probably those are two people with complications, man. Then we know say a lot of sick people there in the world, man. All different types of diseases. Basically, our people are under the curses, man. Deep under the curses. As well as, you know, they have a lot of Edomites and other people from other nations. Have all different type of sickness, man. Diabetes, zin, heart conditions, hypertension, all of them stuff, man. Zin. So basically this sickness will come. I got affect a lot of those people, man. Zin. Says the spread of the disease, which began in China and has seen more than 89,000 cases worldwide and over 3,000 fatalities, prompted panic buying ever since health authorities one that Americans should start preparing for domestic acceleration of the virus. Videos emerge on social media over the weekend of shoppers rushing in to stock up on toilet paper, bottled water, disinfectant, wipes, and sanitizers from California to New York. So right across America, people are prepared, man.
Gone.
Yeah.
You have a lot of, basically people not prepared to them. And watch who are prepared, who are prep. So when things get, when push come to shove, you know, then basically go visit them. Then group up as a team. Because if you speak for sweet boat, well, they shall invade one another.
Gone.
You can't bring up a scripture of the burden of second Jesus.
You can get it, man.
15. And start at verse 14. So you have a lot of men going to basically fight for food. Is it shoot, man, and take them food? Because
this is second Ezra 15.
Man, and this is a future prophecy we're approaching right
and
now,
verse,
man.
And verse 14. Now, I'm going to start. Let's bring out verse 1. It says, behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth,
and
say the Lord.
And that's how we are doing right now. You see, we are speaking the word of a prophecy. Because we live in a time, you see, with a lot of prophecies taking place. Swiftly and speedily.
And as the elder Apostle Tahar has deemed this year the year of prophecy, man. And it's rightly said, because we can see where the prophecies are happening, man.
Gone.
And speedily happening too. See? One behind the other, man.
Gone.
See? It says, and cause them to be written in paper.
Gone.
For they are faithful and true.
For the word of the Heavenly Father as well? Faithful and true. You see me? And we are witnessing that too, because we see, you see me? A lot of prophecies fulfilling right before our eyes.
Which is right, man.
The word of the Heavenly Father is faithful and true. Gone.
It says, fear not the imagination against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee. Hey, that's basically where the Lord said, fear, where people want to imagine about us, how we look. Zin? How would the man say about women? Zin? Who them man are? Zin? Where the man get them knowledge, wisdom, understanding? Which school them go to learn? Zin? Hey, them not going to listen to us, man. Because them look at us as nobody. Zin? It says, for all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Zin? Behold, said the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world.
Don't like what takes place right now. See, this coronavirus thing, waving in the media right now, right across the world.
Which is right, man.
See, it's a part of the plague that Heavenly Father brings upon the world. You see, me? Ultimately, the ICBM missiles them.
Yeah,
you know? The end goal, you know, basically destroy the land of America. You see, because what? It is the vengeance of the Lord, you
can't,
judge
can't.
America for all the wickedness. You see, along with the chariots, them, little powerful laser beams from the chariots, them.
The sword forming death and destruction. Then, verse 14, it says, woe to the world and them that dwell therein.
So, people say, woe to the world and them that dwell therein. You. And the word woe means destruction or suffering.
This is right.
So, live that time, you see me? Destruction of this wicked society. One.
For the sword and their destruction draw it nigh.
Okay, and close that right now. One.
And one people shall stand and fight against another.
Okay, about class war. You know, upper class against the lower class. You
can.
You know?
And you got race war.
Race
also,
war also.
Gun. And swords in their hands.
Swords in their hands, go on.
Guns, knife, machete, whatever a man can get to defend himself in that time, man. Yeah. Zin, a man gonna draw. Zin, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able.
A man shall desire to go into another city and shall not be able, because you have quarantine like we're sitting place right now.
Gun.
You see me, I believe you have in a New York, they say you have 83 people in quarantine in New York.
Gun.
You have an article come out of
CNBC.
CNBC.
Yeah, it come out the other day, man.
Can't. So this is how basically I come up on earth right now, because we say take place now, you see, the beginning of what to come. Hey, because you said that, you speaking about the beginning of sorrows. See, a way more worse things are ways to take place right now across the world. Can't. They're ahead.
Because basically a lot of the numbers of them are here, the numbers will add up. See, because they give you less number than people were infected, man. See, because the government are cover it up, man. Because they don't want to have a panic scared.
You should have a panic, you know?
Yeah. See? It says, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. For because of their pride, the city shall be troubled. The houses shall be destroyed.
The houses shall be destroyed, because you have men basically group up together, you know, and go basically hunt. A lot of these men will basically prepare all these women, will basically prepare them food.
Can't.
You know, go to the supermarket and buy up all these things. There are a lot of men going to come together.
Yeah,
I'm going to hunt them.
I'm going to map them out.
People observe them. All the purpose them. I'm going to observe them. I watch them. So in time to come, they're going to basically war for the food. I guess what? I'm going to give up him food easy so neither. So
they're
going to prepare for them.
Himself, man.
So they're going to have a blood bath, you.
Yeah.
You see?
Because just the other day, we read this article where this man buy up a year supply of food, put in a basement.
Year.
How much it thin. much tin.
Done.
A food, man. Zin.
Old person might come feed them there.
Man.
A lot of men going to hold them there.
A lot of hungry men, man.
Zin. Can't be known. Zin do that.
Time of Jacob's trouble is coming.
Zin. So they're not hungry. They might not steam up.
He says, a man shall have no pity. It says, because of their pride, the city shall be troubled.
One.
The houses shall be destroyed.
The houses,
and men shall be afraid.
And houses shall be destroyed. Men gonna be and men shall be afraid.
Afraid,
so that men gonna be a scarlet. Is of heart attack, scared. In Isaiah 13, he say, pangs and sorrow shall take hold of them. A man will cry like a woman in
travail
pain. And when scripture says, take place.
Trouble,
the time we approach it, man will cry like a woman. Mm. And what the Bible says, go on.
It says, a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword, and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread.
Because of what?
And for a great tribulation.
Because of the lack of bread
and for a great tribulation.
It's a shortage of food. We already see that take place right now.
Because the full storehouses are empty, man.
Can. Yeah, you can't bring up to bread.
See? Because it says, upon his neighbor and for. Because of lack of bread and great tribulation, man. Zin?
Second Ezra 6 and 22.
Alright, this is Second Ezra
6
verse 22.
One.
It says, and suddenly shall the sown places appear unsown.
Suddenly shall the sown place appear unsown.
Zin?
Suddenly. Always keep saying. When they shall think of peace and safety, then sudden destruction shall come upon them, man.
What? The day of the Lord shall come as a thief in the night, man. Then when you're not expecting.
You're least expecting.
Hey, because, Jake Uncle, being around, enjoying themselves, man, living lavishly, carelessly, then going to parties every night and every day, hey, not considering what is going on around them, man. Then putting up memes on the internet, man, making jokes. Of events that are taking place across the world, and not knowing, hey, when the time are coming, when these things are coming down by your sudden, man, hey, what are you going to do, man? As the scripture says, and suddenly shall the sown places appear unsown, and the full storehouses shall suddenly be found empty.
Like supermarket, yo.
See?
The places where you go to basically get certain things,
which is right,
found empty. Yeah, I already see that take place right now. You see, we see that take place in America now. You have a lot of people rushing to buy up all the things them, but they need you. So soon you're going to run out. And guess what? You have shipment. You know, you don't really have a shipment of things that come in again.
Can.
Even I'm out here in Jamaica, we have I do a video on it yesterday. You know, this man basically look at the wharf. I say, look at the wharf.
Can.
It's empty.
The wharf empty, man.
Can. So don't know really are coming because of the coronavirus.
Mash up in life, man.
And so this is what basically we're approaching right now, yo.
And right now, hey, you can walk on the streets out here in Jamaica, basically. You just hear a youngster, me out there a while ago, and I hear a youngster from school. That's about the coronavirus won't reach Jamaica. See? So a lot of them, hey, it is going to come to Jamaica, man. But them attack it, but them take it serious, man. See? Zin, them attack with a hope set now come. But the scripture said these plagues are gonna come, man. Zin? And Jamaica is that place known for highly depending on importation of food. See, and we're not producing enough. So when the liquor at the supermarket run out and the shipment now come from other places across the Caribbean and so forth, man, and different parts of the world like China, United States and stuff, everybody will keep them food in a time of crisis, man. Hey, then you're gonna have great crisis down here. Zin? And we can see how the crime rate high already in Jamaica, so guess what?
Yeah.
In the time to come, it's going to get worse, man.
Yeah, yeah.
260 gone dead from the year start in how much days? Hey, a little over 60 days or so. So hey, that number arise as we speak. See? This. And the trumpet shall give sound.
Give on a surf, sir.
Give, and the trumpet shall give a sound, which when every man hear it, they shall be suddenly afraid.
Gun.
Hey, the trumpet is speaking now. But basically,
trumpet are blowing right now.
The trumpet are blowing. Because we're out here. We're talking it, man. It says, scripture says, shall a trumpet
be blown in a city and the people be not afraid.
Zin? Zin? It says, the Lord will do nothing but show a secret and his servants his prophet, man. That's why we're out here as the prophets, man. Zin, this is our job description. Zin, to bring the word of the Lord, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, unto you, man. Hey, all them other so-called teachers in the churches, the politicians, all of them, would be telling you about prosperity, man. You can't know that they are false prophets, man. See? Because the scripture tell you the job description of a prophet. See? You want to get it?
And at that time
shall friend fight one against another.
Shall friend fight one against another. You see, because when church of food come, guess what? I'm going to pray up. You see, they are my neighbor. You see, me and him good now. But as soon as not food run out, I'm going to want fuel. Hey. I'm not have none.
Hey, the scripture tell you, man, a friend cannot be known
in the time of prosperity.
In the time of prosperity, man.
Right.
See? And an enemy cannot be hid in the time of adversity, man. So when the time of adversity come, you will know who are your friend from, who are your enemy, them time, them, man. So I always laugh and smile with you and pretend with you. Like a boy them with you because you can give them a little handout.
Right.
When the time come when nothing can run and hard times start face them, then you're going to see if they really with you, man. See?
God. Hey, Lord, I'm going to be with him like you because it's all about the elect.
Which is right, man.
See, if I say, Lord, say, we're not going to be ashamed in the evil time, yo. Or in the days of famine. You're going to be satisfied.
Can't,
see, we're covering scripture. You see, we open prayer. You see, we basically, we are pushing straight right across the road in all sincerity. And all honesty, we endure this work until the end, yo.
Which is right.
Because even if I say we're not going to be ashamed, night time to come. You see, it's all about, you know.
Again?
Faith in the Yahweh, bash me and shine. Go ahead.
2 Corinthians 6 and verse 24 again. It says, and at that time shall friends fight one against another, like enemies. See? And the earth shall stand in fear with those that dwell therein. The springs of the fountain shall stand still, and in 3 hours they shall not run.
Right.
See? Yeah, let's jump to verse 16. 18. It says, this 2 Ezra 16 and verse 17, it says, woe is me, woe is me. Who shall deliver me in those days? See? In those evil days, man.
And who are going to deliver? You know, time to come. Because the average people are saying, hey, we keep on saying it, you know. They don't really care about the things we say. I take place. Across the world. Even America, them precious America, they love so much.
Come.
So what take place in America, you have you see me? That's one of the main EMV our people out here in Jamaica, which are mainly from the tribe of Benjamin, is to get to America.
Come.
Get a visa and get to America. And you have people coming back and forward from America, so ultimately going to reach you.
She's right, man.
See me? Regardless of what them think, this virus going to reach you one way or the other.
Come.
So the average people don't really care about what take place out here in Jamaica, or what take place across the world, because guess what? You're not out here yet.
Right.
You see, you know, the market that reality, you know, struck very soon. So people say, woe is me, who will deliver me in those days?
Can.
What will help in any time to come? You see me? Yeah. We hope and pray that Yahweh Bashmir shall deliver us in any time to come, you know. You see, when everybody else above go.
Go on, brother. It says, the beginning of sorrows.
So we're setting place across the world right now. You see me? It's the beginning of sorrow. It's the beginning. You see me? So you have way more worse things there ahead. You know, one.
And great mourning,
one.
The beginning of famine and great death.
The beginning of famine. So the whole supermarket thing we say, oh, I take place in America now, people are run to the supermarket buy up all these things. Is what? The beginning of famine. Go on.
Then, the beginning of famine and great death.
And great death.
The beginning of wars.
Real war tree.
And the powers still stand in fear.
And the powers still stand in fear. All these leaders across the world are going to stand in fear. You see, when this thing escalates, you get, no?
Can. And see the little coronavirus scare that a lot of these leaders across the world in a fear, man. Because they're in a fear of the economy collapse.
Can. That's my next thing too.
Yeah.
The economy collapse.
Can.
And that's what basically bringing what? They RFID microchip. They're shining. They RFID microchip. Because that's what the elite want.
Can. And they push the vaccination program.
Can.
Kill a lot of you people. Also,
can. You have a last year with that basically sleep out ID 2020.
Can. Which is right, man.
Vaccine information. Go on.
It says, the powers shall stand in fear.
Go on.
The beginning of evils. What shall I do when this evil shall come?
What people are going to do when all these things start to take place? What am I going to do? They not think about these things, though. Go on.
It says, behold, famine and plague.
Famine and plague, like coronavirus. Go on.
Go on. And the locusts, they want to take place in Africa right now and across place in China and in the and down there in the Middle East, man, and part of Asia, man. They swarm in the place like mad ants.
And I'm sure it's a judgment that they've far to you.
Yeah, can.
You see, because it's where they reach from Africa, now they reach China.
It is right, man.
These locusts. Going back to Asia and to Egypt. So that plague that are really far away is called smite Egypt with you.
That's what's gonna bring the famine too. Zin? That's gonna bring the famine, man.
What?
Zin? That's it says, behold, famine and plagues, tribulation and anguish.
Tribulation and anguish, go on.
Are sent as scourges for amendment.
All these things sent for what? Scourges for amendment. All these things, Heavenly Father, used to punish our people. But guess how people now consider? They've been punished for all their wicked ways.
Which is
or
right,
people
man.
Which are you so-called Negroes and Latinos and Native American Indians. They're not consider the wickedness on the base of you. So you say, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish, all of these things Heavenly Father sent as well. Scourges. Is it for amendment? One.
But for all these things, they shall not turn away from their wickedness.
But for all these things we say take place right across the world now, people still never turn from their wickedness. Yo. They might continue to do it. Two-third of people.
Because
until the time of destruction.
They're stiff-necked and rebellious, man. That's the thing with the people, man. They're stiff-necked people.
See?
A bunch of evildoers, man. Because, hey, it is evil, it is easy. So, like, it's easy to do evil than to do good, man. In this society, man. Hey, wickedness is glorified, man. In this society.
Yes.
It says, It says, but for all this, the wickedness shall not, no, nor be always mindful of the scourges. It says, behold, victuals shall be so good cheap upon earth that they shall think themselves to be in good case.
Can.
Then, as you know, hey, food and clothes cheap, man. You can
in
get
America.
Cheap things from China, all about, and them things. So people, hey, people life, they can, even though people say them are suffer, about them still can't afford to buy some things, clothes and them things, they put on them, shoes on them foot,
man.
Clothes to wear, zin. Them can still put a little food in them pots, so boy, them say, boy, it's not so hard, zin. It's hard, but it's not hard, because people complain, zin, in good case. And even then, shall evils grow up on the earth, sword, famine, and great confusion.
Great confusion. Live that time on the greatest confusion. Ever
right now, man. Because right now people up and down, like when they lick, when they go some lick all a fall and animal all over the place are flatter. Bloop, 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 bloop. There's some people all over the place like mad and snow.
Gone, because you look across the world now with this whole LGBTQ thing that spread. You know, I become the norm to people right across the world. You know. So we live in a confused time, you know,
which is right,
we walk to Babylon. You see me? America, we have life, or the so-called white man, we have life. Because, you know, so the whole LGBTQ thing walk to UN.
Can.
You know, part of the UN goal.
So, hey, when you look funny, when you see a man, a big, growing, strong man, see an Israelite man, like a basketball player, doing weird, have it okay with him son. Become a transgender man, in 12-year-old son. See? Him allow that to happen, man. So you can't say, hey, this place is finished, man. It's
right.
Over, man. Then says, for many of them that dwell upon earth shall perish of famine.
God, and famine is one of the terriblest way to die. Scripture tell that. But they by the sword, than by basically by famine, you know. Worst way to die is by famine.
See?
One.
And the other, that escape the plagues,
God,
the hunger, shall the sword destroy, man.
So I'll always escape the famine and get put to death by one sword.
Yeah, because,
the weapon.
Because guess what? That's going back to a lot of you people where have things store up. See? Store up in your house, man. Because guess what? You're not things about why. To you store up your things, them. You got your piece, it's okay for you. Because you have food for it. But the man who has no food for it, I come look for you with him gun to kill you to take your food, man. That is what's gonna happen, man. See?
Yes.
It says, this is
gonna be. Right, exactly as the brother I say. You see, you're gonna have a lot of people hunting you.
Can.
You see, right across the world.
Like it,
especially doing? rich neighborhood.
Can.
Right. I must say most of food.
Yeah. Like all the money from all, for example, out here in Jamaica, I have the money from down in the ghetto. Hey, they're gonna start go for Nabuk and up a Red Hills and all, guard the town and them place there. But the rich people, they need to go look food, man. See? Because you know them rich people are for them food to work. And them were in the city. I go on coming to the country here, I come look food, come read man plantation and all them something there to me.
Hey, so you have total madness, yo.
Yeah, it's all of a confusion.
Because if you land on the side and tell me, out here in Jamaica, would I say, dog, them and suffer. See,
which is right.
Wash me a shine aside, that time to come. Is in your doom. Is it? So that means I say, praises and honor to you,
how wash me a shine, wash me a cockadash.
The blunders, the pastors and elders of great men stone. Shalom to all our brothers and mouth, they are pushing through, can't you push through? Because pretty soon you're going to leave this wicked society. Shalom.
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 Hey, wow.